Everybody knows that my next guest has just won this Tony Award for her deliciously funny performance as Googie Gomez in the Broadway hit comedy The Ritz. And I think that most everybody also knows that she won this Oscar for her role as Anita in West Side Story, the movie. But did you also know that she's a Triple Crown winner because she won this Grammy Award also? And here is the $64,000 question. Do you remember her in this classic?
If you see a chaba flower in your bat broken like this, it will be the sign that I have come for you. Watch for it.
I will be ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Yul Brynner's former daughter from The King and I. She's also known to me as Rita the Sweeta Moreno.
Hey,
what you doing here, man? Hey, qué hace, qué pasa, qué de nuevo?
What do you
say? Hey, what's this? How do you feel when you see that? I mean, it's not one of your dramatic highlights.
Well, so. I look cute.
You did look very cute. Very, very.
I was a lot younger.
How do you feel being an overnight success for the fifth or sixth time?
Terrific. I want to tell you something. When you're 43 and looking good and it happens again, it's fabulous.
It's super. She's great. I don't know how many of you all in the audience have seen The Ritz, but it is very, very funny.
And, isn't that a funny show?
And I know there's going to be a movie. I hope that you play that movie. That's a funny act. I mean, I swear that you did that once when I was at a party.
Yes.
You sang a song that was like that character, but years ago.
I've been playing that Googie Gomez character for years. In fact, it started with West Side Story. And it's just that Terrence McNally, who wrote The Ritz, saw me do that song at a party, and he was sitting on a bed and fell off, but he was laughing so hard, and said to me, "Someday I have to write a part for that character." And I thought, sure. And he did. He really did. She's a wonderful character. Well,
do at least the party version of Googie.
The party version? Well, can I sing that song?
Sure,
can
we give,
okay. Well, in the Ritz, Googie Gomez, for starters, is a girl of lots of guts and no talent at all. No talent, but lots of guts. And she sings at a nightclub inside a gay baths called The Pits. And that's nothing. Come see the play. And she comes out with a great fanfare and tom-toms. So you get the feeling when she comes out with this costume on that she's going to sing some low-down blues. And instead she sings, "I had a dream. A dream about your baby. It's going to come through, baby. They think that we're through. But, baby." And she sings, "Everything's coming up roses." In sort just of, that voice.
Sort of. I mean, the whole thing is done in that dialogue. That's great. When you won the Tony Award, I was watching it. Obviously, you were the high point dramatically of the show, and you said that, well, you say what you said. I thought it was very appropriate and absolutely true.
Well, it wasn't a prepared speech, but I did know that if I won, I wanted to mention two things. One, to remind people that I'm Puerto Rican, and two, to remind them that I do discriminate between supporting actress and leading lady. So I said, Rita Moreno is thrilled, but Rosa Dolores Alberio from Humacao, Puerto Rico is undone. And then I did say, Miss supporting actress, whomever you might have been, I'm a little regretful because I am not the supporting actress of The Ritz. Yes. I am the leading lady of The Ritz.
Absolutely.
And I understand that this has happened before with the Tonys. A friend of mine who was writing a journalist, was writing a piece on the Tonys, told me, he called me one day laughing hysterically, and he said, "You think you're in trouble?" He said, "Do you know that one year Yul Brynner was selected as best supporting actor for The King and I. He played the king.
The King and I was best supporting actor.
And Tom Bosley, who did Fiorello, who played Fiorello, was also supporting actor.
It's so contrived, some of those awards.
Well,
I'm glad
well,
we got
it's a
recognition.
Mystery. I'm happy to get it, and that's certainly why I went up and accepted it. I just feel that it's very important for us Puerto Rican folk to gather as many accolades as we can. And yeah. I wasn't about to turn that down.
Well, you did great. Not really sure. We have been pretty close over the years. I guess there aren't very many of us in on this side of lights or cameras, regardless of the context or the vehicle. I wonder, you know, one time I interviewed you, I remember for a minority show they have on local TV here in New York, and we talked about the fact that almost every movie role you had when you went to Hollywood were these Latin spitfires, you know, these hot enchiladas, you know. You show a lot of teeth and you say, hey, you know,
you flare your nostrils
you.
And think, junkie pig, you know, like Conchita no more, I killed you.
and then, of course, you had West Side Story, which was, of course, written
yeah, it's different.
Music by those two famous Puerto Rican people, Stephen Sondheim and Leonard Bernstein. but you won the Oscar for that.
Oh, too bad. Too very bad.
What happened after the Oscar? What happened with your career?
What happened after the Oscar is that this was in 1962. I was offered more roles like Anita in West Side Story, except without the substance. Anita was a wonderful part, and I'll be forever grateful for having been chosen to do that. But I didn't want to play that role for the rest of my life. So when I won the Oscar, I decided, okay, I'm going to turn down every Spitfire role that's offered to me from now on. Ha ha, I showed them. I didn't work in a movie for 7 years.
We'll talk about that and a lot of other things about this wonderful lady when we come back. How'd you get into public TV and the Electric Company, which is a very, very, you know, it's
so
great
simple.
For kids.
I was devoted to Sesame Street. I still am. I love it. I also think that the Muppets are the most brilliant people on earth. They're real artists. And somebody who was casting the Electric Company simply called me up and said, we've got Bill Cosby who's going to do this show that's going to help to teach children, slow children, to read. And that's all they needed to say. I said, I'd love to do it. And I'm still with them. We're starting our fourth season. In fact, tomorrow morning I start taping again, our fourth season, and it's a show that I never want to stop doing as long as I'm free to do it. I love it.
Okay, we have a clip, a very funny
clip. Oh, this is a super
one.
I love this. Yeah.
Take a look at it.
Thank you.
Isn't that a super way to teach things?
It really is.
Wasn't he funny?
They really learn that way, the kids, too.
And you know, he was wearing jam jar glasses. He couldn't see
Steve
past
Allen
his
used
nose.
To wear those.
Oh, he's such fun to work with, that man.
Well, how's your head now? You're a big hit, you know.
And how's my head?
Yeah. How you feel?
Oh,
everything cool?
Oh, I'm so terrific. I'm not cool at all.
Yeah, no, how does it feel?
Cool is out. I mean, passion and involvement is in. I'm so happy.
What are you going to do if the Ritz ever closes?
Oh,
which it might not.
All kinds of things. All kinds of things. There has been all sorts of network interest in me because of the Ritz.
About time.
Several plays have been offered to me. You can't imagine how good that feels after, I mean, I've busted my buns for a long time. And I know a lot of people who have busted their buns and who are very talented, to whom it doesn't happen. So you really have to learn to savor those good moments so that they'll see you through the bad moments later on.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rita Moreno. We'll be right back.
Come fly with me, let's fly.